Hello, friend. Just wanted to share a real quick experience that I just had that I thoroughly enjoyed. I was just with a very, very pleasant gentleman that I met very recently, and he is a very heart-centered leadership teacher and a messenger, and I thoroughly enjoyed the conversation that I had with him. Almost 2 hours. And so the conversation was in a hotel right here, where he was supposed to go to a mastermind meeting. Well, not a mastermind meeting, but a networking meeting. Hi, Carrie. A networking meeting. And so we met an hour before this networking meeting, so we have time to chat and expand in the lobby until people came and the meeting started. And so our conversation actually continued for 2 hours. At the end of the conversation, near the end of the conversation, I had the option to come in and participate in the networking event. And so near the end of the conversation, I was checking in with myself and how I feel about it. And this is something that I've been doing lately. And the title of this video is Being Binary, and I'll explain what that means. And so I was checking in with myself whether I felt it was the right thing for me to stay for the networking meeting or leave after we decide that we're done with our co-creation. And it didn't feel quite right. And usually in my very recent past, hi Ray, I would have gone like this. I would have gone, you know what, it's a networking event, and networking events, I can always meet somebody who, hi Mimi, who can influence my life in a positive way, I can benefit in a way, maybe I should stay. I wasn't able before to check in with myself and see how I feel. Or let me state it in another way. I knew how I always felt, but I always ignored it because I was letting my conscious mind override what my true self, what my spirit, what my intuition tells me. And so I always went against my intuition, pretty much always. And even if I was listening to my intuition in the past, the conversation went like this, it kind of doesn't feel like right, but I think I should stay. And then, should I stay or should I go? Hi, Emily. Should I stay or should I go? And I always went like right there, one leg leaving, one leg staying, and I wasn't sure. It was never a firm decision. It's like going to a restaurant. I like all these items, but let me see, do I want this? Yeah, I'll stay with this. And then the waiter comes and I go, this, oh, wait, I'm not sure. Maybe it's this. I like all of them. What should I select? And so I always, my entire life, I was like this. Until recently, something started changing. And so back to this meeting today. I went, do I feel right about staying with this event, staying for this event or not? And I didn't feel right. And so at the end, he asked me, he said, do you want to stay? I said, no. He said, why? I said, because it doesn't feel right. And a minute later, as we were saying, you know, we were saying goodbye to each other, one of the guys from the meeting came and he introduced himself to me and he said, are you staying for the meeting? I said, no. And he said, why? And I said, because it doesn't feel right. And the gentleman that I was with originally said, I truly liked that. You know, you didn't give whatever excuse that you don't want to stay. You just told him what you told me. And it made me think for a second. I was not able before to do that. I was not able to be that upfront and tell people how I feel. And now I really enjoy that level of freedom that I have achieved. And so for me, being binary, and by the way, I didn't come up with this term, I borrowed it from one of my mentors. Being binary is very, very empowering. So the first thing is I check in with myself. How do I really feel about that? And I go with what the intuition tells me. If it tells me that it's right, then I go with it. If it tells me that it doesn't feel right, then I go against it. And I don't question it anymore. I don't let my logical mind override how I feel. So that's the first part. And the second part is, I tell it the way it is, the way it feels. I don't sugarcoat it for people anymore. And I just noticed that people appreciate that much, much better. I didn't come up with an excuse. Hi, Eric. Hi, Ergen. I didn't come up with an excuse. I just told it the way it is. And both gentlemen appreciated it very much. And so it's freedom. It's one of these levels of freedom, and I thoroughly enjoy it. I go by how I feel, and I'm not the least bit afraid to tell people it's a yes or it's a no. And if it's a no, this is why it's a no, because it feels that way. It's awesome. And so I wish that for you as well. I don't know where you are in your own level of development, but I wish that for you as well. And at the end, I'll turn the camera around so I let you experience this beautiful western side of Austin, Texas, right where it's hill country. It's 80 miles away to the left of Austin, all the way. It's beautiful. The east part of Austin is very flat, and this is very, very hilly like that. So anyway, be more binary, guys. It's another level of freedom, and it feels wonderful there. I'll see you next time. As always, love and light. Bye.